Right, so hello, are you guys all right there?
Yes, sir.
How many are we now? So 10. Okay, so in here I forgot to write PCL at VB. So we have I1 plus I2 and minus I3. So in here, this will serve as our reference, okay, in knowing or getting the unknowns. So as you guys can see right here, we have to find the voltage drop across I1 or R1, R2, R3, and then the value of I1, the value of I2, and then the value of I3. Cannot write anything. Why? VR1, VR2, and then VR3. All right. So from here, so we will actually apply the Ohm's law for us to be able to get the VA and VB and then VC. Okay. And then one more thing. So when we see a nodal voltage, we always have this reference node or the ground node. Okay, so you can call either of those two. So in here, we always deal or we always consider the ground node as the node that is connected with our ground. That's why they call that one the ground node or the reference node. Okay. And one more thing, the ground node or reference node is always connected with our negative source. Okay. So right here, going there, right here, and then going there. So that is why the ground node is always equal to zero. Or the VB is equal to zero. So in here, we could actually label this one already as your VB is equal to 0 volt. Okay. So in here, we have to look for the, forget to mention, we also have to find the value of your VA, VB, VC, and then VB. And if you can, if you're going to take a look on this one, VB is already like a bonus. Okay, the same with VA and VC. They are already about a bonus. But for the VB, that's the one that we have to find, okay, basically. And in here, for us to be able to get the VA, VB, VC, and then VB, so again, we'll use this one as your reference formula. So for you to be able to get the I1, okay, we have this formula, V1 minus R1, right? Coming from Ohm's law. And as you guys can see right here, for you to be able to get the V1, okay, you have to find the VR1, okay, or the voltage drop across R1. So in here, we can actually say that I1 is equal to VA minus VB divided by R1. So were you guys able to get this one? On how did we get VA minus VB? All right, so I guess not yet. Anyway, so again, we have the rule, okay, the thumb rule when it comes to electricity. We have the VH minus VL, okay? Then this will give you the flow of current or the flow of voltage. It's always the higher voltage minus the lower voltage. And as you guys can see right here, we have a flow of current, okay, coming from this point going right here. So in that case, we already know that the voltage at VA is already higher than the voltage at VB, since that is a flow of current. Okay. So That is why we have here VA minus VB. Okay, this is equal to your current, okay, as your flow of current or voltage. All right. So are we clear so far on how did we get this VA minus VB?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And the reason why we have this R1, since again, we are basing our answer or our formula on this I1. And again, what is our I1? I1 is equal to V1 divided by R1. Okay, so you can see that this V1 is your VA minus VB, okay, divided by R1. Okay, and that's how we've got that R1 right there. All right, so I hope that one is clear. And for the I sub 2, okay, so basically it's the same process. Okay, we have the VH minus VL. So the higher voltage, potential voltage right here is the VC, since we have this flow of current. And then the lower potential is your VB. So right here we have VC minus VB divided by R2. Okay, so basically the same concept with this one. So if you want to get the I sub 2, you have to get the voltage drop across that R2. Okay, and then you will have this. Okay. So I hope we are clear with that one. And then for the last one, we have negative I sub 3, wherein I3 is the same. So V3 divided by R3, wherein V3 is equal to, so since we have this flow of current now from this node to this node, then basically we have higher potential voltage than the node letter D. Okay, so in here we have VB minus VB divided by I3. So from here we have VB minus VB. Okay, so sorry for my letters. It's not consistent. We have small letter here, we have big letter here. Anyway, so we have here divided by RT is equal to zero. So there you go. We now have our main equation. So this is just your reference equation. But I think I'd call this one as our equation one. Yeah, equation one, and then we have here your equation number two. Okay, but this is our main working equation. All right, so are we clear so far on how did we get this equation number two?
Yes, sir.
All right. And then once you already have this kind of equation, then you can now fill up the values of each of those variables. So VA, so at this point, we still have 10 volts. Okay. At this point, we still have 20 volts. But at this point, we don't know what is VB anymore, since we have a voltage going there and a voltage going here, and then we don't know the voltage drop across here and the voltage drop across here. So right here, just simply fill up or substitute the value, okay, whatever we have. So 10 for VA, and then VB is, of course, unknown. And then R1 is 10 ohms, okay, which is this one, plus... So we have here a VC of 20 volts minus. So VB is still unknown. And R2 is 20 ohms minus VB is, of course, we don't know. But in VD, since we already know that that one is our reference node, then VD is equal to zero. Okay, so VB minus zero is still VB. So I will not include that one anymore. So divided by R3 is equal to 40 ohms. Equal to zero. Okay, and as you guys can see, we only have one unknown variable, which is the VB. Okay, so just simplify this one, and then we'll be able to get the value of our VB already. Okay, so what I will do is, so I will multiply the entire equation, okay, by 40. Let's eliminate our denominators. So 40 divided by 10 is times 4 times 10 minus VB plus. So 40 divided by 20 is 2. So times 2 of 20 minus VB. And right here, so this will just simply cancel. So we have here minus VB is equal to 0. And then from here, so you can just distribute 40 minus 4VB plus 2 times 20 is 40 minus 2VB and then minus VB. And then right here, of course, you can now combine same terms. So 40 plus 40 will give you 80. And then right here, we have minus 4, minus 2, and then minus 1, negative 6, negative 7. So negative 7VB is equal to 0. And then from here, you can just transfer this one on the other side. So VB is equal to positive VB. 80 divided by 7. All right. And VB is equal to
11.43.
So very good, Mr. Salvalion. Oy, Mr. Salvalion. Hindi ka pa nag-completion sa electro ko, ha?
Balik ko na sa finals yan.
Bahala ka dyan. Malapit na matapos. Alright, so in here, we have a voltage value of a voltage value of node B on node B of 11.43 volts. Okay, so we have the value of VA already, which is 10 volts. So check. And VB is already checked. VC is already given, 20 volts. And VD is already given, which is 0 volts. So for the VR1, so it's now simple, I guess, since we have the value of your I1, I2, I3. Yeah. Okay, so let's try to solve for the VR1. So for the VR1, of course, we have I1 and then R1. So what is our I1? We already have that one. Yes, we haven't solved for that one. All right. So in here, we have to get the... Let me just go back. Maybe it's only to solve the voltage drop, not the current. Ah, I see. Now, if you want to find the currents, then you can use the superposition theorem. So the main goal of nodal voltage analysis is only for voltages. Which is mainly for voltage drop on each of those components. So in here, I won't be able to show on how to solve for the I1, I2, and R3. But for the VR1, can we also solve that one? Yeah, I guess it's possible since we already have the value of VB. So again, for you to be able to get the voltage drop at this point, so just get this one. Ah, where is it one? So VC minus VB. Okay, that's already your voltage drop on R2. And then for the VR1, so VR1 is equal to VA minus VB. Okay, so just deduct that one, then you will be able to get the voltage drop across this. And the same with your right here, your R3, your VR3. So VB minus VB. So since VD is 0, so the voltage drop on the VR3 is the value of VB. There you go. Well, anyway, our main objective is to solve for the voltage across this circuit. So VA minus VB to get this one. And then VC minus VB to get this one. And then VB minus VD to get this one. And then the value of VB, which is 80 divided by 7, wherein we have 11.42 volts. pulse. And then in here, since we already know, the voltage that is flowing at this point, then we can solve for the I3, okay? The I3 only, but we don't have the I1 and I2. So in here, we have, 11.43. Divided by R3. R3 is 40. So it will give you 0.28 or 2 divided by 7. Or 0.286. Okay. All right. So are we clear so far after this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in here, they didn't show the VA, VB, I mean VA, VC, and VD anymore because they are already given. Okay, so your main question here is to find the VB and then the I3. Well, actually, the VB only is enough. Anyway, so I have another example here, which is the same circuit, but instead of voltage source, we have here a current, okay? So find I1, I2, I3, VR1, VR2, VR3, VA, VB, and VC. And then VB is, of course, already given, which is zero. So with this equation, of course, you have to apply KCL again. You're going to apply the nodal voltage analysis. So in here, we have a current that is flowing on the VB. So I1, positive. And then we have here a current. So we already know that we have here positive I2, okay? And then we have a current that is leaving this VB, which is the R3, okay? So that is why we have here minus I3. So as a result, we have this I1 plus I2 is equal to I3. Or I can go back with this one, with the original one, but I just would like to eliminate the negative sign. So why I've used this one instead. All right, so the first thing that we need to find is, of course, the VB before we can find the I3 or the rest of the unknown values. So again, just by using the concept of Ohm's law on I is equal to V divided by R, so we can find the I1 is equal to V1 divided by R1. And again, this V1 is equal to VA minus VB, or a voltage or higher potential voltage minus the lower potential voltage, okay? And then, of course, divided by R1, all right? And then right here, so we have our reference equation, okay, which is, of course, the I1. So right here, for you to be able to get the I1 or the voltage drop across R1, you have to use this one. So VA minus VB divided by R1. So can you guys still follow up to this point? So this one is the same with our last example anyway. So are we clear with this one?
Yes, sir.
Again, just follow this one. For the I2, we have it on the right side. So again, the higher potential voltage is VC. So that's why we have VC minus VB divided by the R2 equal to the I3. Which is VB minus VB divided by R3. And then since we already have, or we already know that VB is zero, then let's put there zero. And then right here, where is that one? So I1, so we have here 30 for the VA, and then VB is of course unknown. And then for the R1, we have 5 ohms. And then for the I2, since we don't have a voltage source in here, the current source is already, or the current is already given. So just simply write here 3. Okay, so instead of writing this one, so that one is actually equal with 3 amps already, okay, coming from our current source. All right, and then equal to VB minus 0 divided by 3. All right, and then simplify this one further by multiplying the entire equation by 15 to eliminate the denominator. So we've come up with this one. So 90 minus 3 VB plus 45 equal to 5 VB. Okay. So 15 divided by 5 is 3. So 3 times 30 is 90. And then 3 minus 3 minus VB is negative 3 VB plus 45. So 15 times 3 is 45. And right here, 15 divided by 3 is 5. So that's why we have 5 VB. All right. And then just add similar terms. So 90 plus 45 will give you 135. And then still have negative 3 VB is equal to 5 VB. And then transfer this negative 3 VB on the right side. So we have here 135 is equal to 5 VB plus 3 VB. So here you can add similar terms again. So 5 VB plus 3 VB is 8 VB. And then right here, you can now get the value of your VB. So VB is equal to 135 divided by 8. And then if you're going to put that one on our calculator, you will get 16.875 volts, right? So now that we have the VB, you can now actually solve for the I3. Okay. But I would like to start with I1 first. Okay. So again, for you to be able to get the I1, so just follow this one. So VA minus VB divided by R1. So whatever is the result, then that is your I1. Okay, coming from our equations a while ago. Alright, so VA is 30 minus VB is 16.875 divided by 5 will give you 2.625 amps. Alright, so I hope that you guys are checking my solutions right here if we have the same answer. So can you guys still follow up to this point?
Yes, sir.
So is this correct?
Sir. Yes, po tama, sir.
For the I3, so of course, just get that one right here. We have VB minus VB divided by R3. So just substitute their corresponding values. So VB is 16.875, VD is 0. So 16.875 divided by 3 will give you 5.625 amps. Okay, so that's the value of our I3. And then for the I2, so again, it's already given, but I just showed here the solution by using the KCL. Okay, or you can actually use this one, okay, VC minus VB. Okay, so it will give you the same answer. So VC minus VB. How about we do that one? VC, where is our VC? We don't have VC, so we cannot apply this one, okay? Since we have to look for the value of VC first. So that's why we have used this one, okay, the KCL one, for you to be able to get the I2, which is 3 amps. All right, anyway. And the next one is you can look for the VR1 since we already have the I1, I2, and I3. So for the VR1, so we have here I1 times R1. So I1 is 2.625 amps times R1 is 5 amps. 5 amps rather. So 2.625 times 5 will give you 13.125 volts. So that's the voltage drop across R1. Or you can just simply use this one, VA minus VB. Okay, so again, it will give you the voltage drop across that resistor as long as the value of your VB is correct. Okay, so in here, VA is, where is our VA? Here, 30 volts. So 30 volts minus your VB, which is 16.875, it will give you 13.125 volts. So are we clear so far up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How about the others?
Yes, sir.
All right. So here's the continuation of the example number two. So solving for VR2, so you can use this one I2 times R2. So I2 is of course 3 amps, and then your resistor 2 is 4. So 3 times 4 will give you 12 volts, right? And then for the VR3, so you can use I3 times R3. So 5.625 for the I3, right? Where is that? Right here, 5.625. And times 3 for the R3. Okay. So just do the math, and then it will give you 16.875 volts. All right. And then VA is already given. So it's 30 volts. And VB is also already solved, which is 16.875. Now we have to look for VC. Okay. So in looking for VC, so we can use the entire mean working equation a while ago. Okay. Since you already have the VA and VB, then the only one unknown is VC. Okay. So in here, just substitute the given known values. So VA is 30, VB is 16.875, R1 is 5, VC is unknown, VB is 16.875, and then R2 is 4, and VB is 16.875, and then VB is 0, and R3 is 3. Okay, and then just simplify this one a little bit more. So if you're going to compute for this one, it will give you 2.625. And if you're going to compute this one, it will give you 5.625. And then right here, so what did I do next? Okay, so I multiply the entire equation by 4 to eliminate the denominator of your VC right here. So 4 times 2.625 will give you 10.5. So of course, this one will be canceled. Okay, and yeah, it will give you VC minus 16.875 is equal to, so 4 times 5.625 will give you 22.5. And then from here, you can now add same terms, so 10.5, but not yet. Okay. So what I did is I transferred everything on the right side, and then the left side is solving for the VC. So just do the math right here, and then it will give you 28.875 volts. Okay, so that is the value of our VC. So now we can use this VC to solve for the I2. Okay, if you want still to apply that one in solving the I2. Anyway, and yeah, here's another solution. So we have here the first solution for the VC, but we have another one right here, which is using the VH minus VL, or the highest higher voltage minus the lower voltage. So it is equal with the I2 times R2. So where did this I2 R2 came from? So this one actually is actually based from the VR2 is equal to I2 times R2. Okay, so for you to be able to get the VR2, again you have to get the highest higher voltage and then minus the lower voltage. So in here, our higher voltage potential is VC, and then the lower voltage potential is VB. That is why we have here VC minus VB is equal to I2 times R2. Okay, and since we are looking for VC, so we substitute the given value. So VB is 16.875, I2 is 3, and then 4 is R2. And then I just transfer this one on the right side, and it will give you this kind of result. So 3 times 4 is 12, and then this one will become positive. So 12 plus 16.875 will give you 28.75 volts, okay, which is the same with our first solution. So were you guys able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
All right, so we're done. So conclusion, generally, nodal voltage analysis is more appropriate when there are larger number of current sources around. OK? Okay, so yeah, either gusto, so superposition theorem and a nodal voltage are actually kind of similar with each other. They have the same goal, okay, to get the voltage drop, the currents, etc., etc. And we have here video samples, so make sure to check those YouTube links. So it will help you understand more what is a nodal voltage all about. So yeah, that's it for the module 6. So this is already our last meeting before your midterm exam. So would you guys like to have a quiz on this coming Tuesday, Friday? On this coming Tuesday, quiz for nodal analysis and superposition theorem. Or would you guys like to use that allotted meeting for you to review and finish all of the other activities that you need to finish on other subjects that you have? What do you guys like? Quiz or free time?
Free time.
Break time, sir.
Your time.
Free time?
Free time.
Free time.
Free time, sir.
All right. So if that is what you guys would like to happen, then make sure to review a lot of examples when it comes to nodal and superposition. Okay, because I will not give any activity anymore aside from the practice exercises. So, as always, perfect the practice exercises first before, you know, saying that you were already able to understand it fully. And, well, one more thing. So, I have already published this one. So, I thought that I have already published this one yesterday, but since that it wasn't, since I checked this one a while ago, and this one isn't published. So I've just published it now. So make sure to visit this one before the due date, which will be on March 19. All right? So your midterm exam will be on March 19 also. Okay. So 3:30 to 7:30, same with our class hours. All right. So coverage is, of course, the module from the start up to the last module, which is module 6. So, yeah. And later on, I will publish this one once I have finished the case study number 3. So I'm still thinking up a topic on what you guys will discuss, okay, on this discussion. All right. So, yeah, that's it for our 2 modules. So any question so far? Additional question or clarification?
Answer.
All right, so if you guys do not have a question anymore, then you may now go and see you guys on finals. So good luck. And thank you guys for coming.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, din, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
So pag may question kayo, message nyo lang ako. So magre-reply naman ako.
Sige po, sir. Thank you po.
Thank you, sir.
Sige. Thank you, Dad.
Sir. Sir. Oh. Paano nga ako pa-stop ng record?
Ano?
Pa-stop po ng record.
Wala nang... Hindi ko ma-stop.